Gray here, coming to you live from Port Douglas. It is a little bit overcast today, and the sun is trying to get out behind the clouds. I'm sure it'll sneak out a little bit later on. Aiming for a top of 27 today. Currently it's 22 degrees. The humidity is sitting at 64%, so it's a little bit on the sticky side, but not too bad. Those tides are getting to that sort of pointless stage again. We've got high tide this morning at 9:54 a.m. at 2 metres, and low tide at the end of the day at 3:48 p.m. at 1.2 metres. So it's a pretty high-low tide, if there is such a thing. So really, ideally, wait a few days for getting out and seeing a few crocs on the river. But look, side, it's still pretty good because the water is still quite cool, so you are still seeing crocs up there. It's not as though you're missing out, so it's still not too bad to get out and about on that one. The joke of the day, I'm going to actually read this one out because it's been sent over for my good mate Rick Brown over there in New York. G'day Rick, how you doing? I know you've watched this. Rick is an umbrophile. I can hear you say, what the hell is an umbrophile? Well, I won't get into the technicalities too greatly, but what it means is somebody who is absolutely passionate and fanatical about solar eclipses. And yes, we have a solar eclipse, a total solar eclipse, coming up in Port Douglas in November 2012. I was just on the phone to the editor of the Gazette a minute ago, actually, who's just reminded me about all of this, that the hype's starting to build slowly about that. And I can say at this stage it's just about impossible to get a room in Port Douglas, but there are plenty available, and there are a lot of accommodation providers being extremely greedy and cheeky, and I don't approve of it at all. Don't milk the customer. Rule number one in any business. But anyway, that aside, that's up to them to decide. So there will be rooms available. Do not panic. You won't miss out if you want to come up for the eclipse. But you want to start looking at it now. People are, as I said, being cheeky and trying to charge ridiculous amounts of money. It's caused the London Olympics a world of grief too. This exact same pathetic behaviour. But anyway, as I said, that's up to them. I'm not going to tell people what they should and shouldn't do. But I'll read the joke and I'll get off my high horse. How about that? A woman and a baby are in a doctor's examining room, waiting for the doctor to come in for the baby's first exam. The doctor arrived and examined the baby, checking his weight and being a little bit concerned, and asked if the baby was breastfed or bottle-fed. Breastfed, she replied. Well, stripped out of her waist, the doctor ordered. She did. He pictured the nipples breastfed, rubbed both breasts for a little while, and a very professional and detailed examination. Monitoring to her to get dressed, the doctor said, "No wonder this baby is underweight. You don't have any milk." He said, "I know," she said, "I'm his grandmother. But I'm glad I came."